Great! Welcome back. We're going to work on the practice problem from linear regression. So that's going to be the first exercise we're going to work on. So you can read the text here. What we want to do is the bank try to predict the number of applications as a function of prime interest rate. So they try to use the prime interest rate to explain banks. Number of applications is our y, and x is interest rate, right? Okay, so they collect the data of 20 different months. The software used here is stat graphics. Regardless of the software you use, the output should be somewhat identical. We see there's a slope estimate and there's an intercept estimate. There's a ANOVA table, okay, and a bunch of other goodness of fit estimates, right? So part A, we were asked to recover the missing values of A, B, C, D. We talked about there's a relationship between the estimate, the standard error, and also the t-statistics. Most specifically, the relationship is a t-stat. It is the estimate divided by the standard error, right? Okay, so we can use this relationship to recover missing values here. So for A should be equal to 3800 divided by 348. Okay, so it is a 3847 divided by 348986. You can use your calculator to do that. And I was able to calculate this is to be 11.026. And next is we can recover C. So for C, what we have here is C divided by 50 something gives a negative 7. So similarly, you should be able to see C is the product of those two. Right. C is 398.305. Okay. So what we're going to do next is we try to figure out B and D, which are respective p-values. So we have the t-statistic, we try to figure out the p-value. So we can use t.dist function to figure that one out. So the p-values for all of this test is actually testing for two-tailed test. I'm going to use t.dist to figure out a one tail, which is usually lower tail, and then multiply by 2 to get two-tailed. So the first one I'm going to try is going to be for B. So the test statistic is 11. So that is 11026. And we have to put down the degrees of freedom. So degrees of freedom is n minus k minus 1. N sample size 20. We used a 1 explanatory variable for this one. That's the interest rate only. So the degrees of freedom is 18. We can put 18 here and then ends with a 2, right? But this only gives us a lower tailed, and in order to figure out a p-value for two-tailed one, so B is a two-tailed probability. That's 2 times this quantity. So that's t dot dist. Right, you just have to copy everything else here. If you use Excel, you should be able to see that this t dot dist gives you a very tiny probability. 2 multiplied by that is also very small. So it's going to be somewhere close to 0. So close to 0. You can repeat the same procedure for D as well. That's also close to 0. So we were able to recover A, B, C, D here. Okay, so let's take a look at the next question here. The next question is part B. It's the statement when the interest rate declines, the bank gets more requests, right? So this question actually says when interest rate, which is X, when it drops, okay, Y, the number of applications will increase. Okay, So this kind of relationship can be measured by the slope. So when does it happen when x drops, y increases? That means when slope is negative. So question B is actually asking the same question as whether beta slope, you can use beta 1, is less than 0. Right? So from the sign of inequality of the alternative, sometimes we use 1 or A. Okay, so we can see this is a lower tailed test. Right? This is related with slope. So that's going to be related with this row here, the second row. Okay, we are able to see it's a negative beta. Negative 398 is a relatively big number. So we know for layman's term, this is a very substantial practical significance. But we are more interested in the statistical significance. To see the statistical significance, we have to do a hypothesis test like what we have here, which involves calculating the test statistic and also the p-value, right? So the test statistic is negative 7.96. And now we have to figure out what the p-value is. This is a lower tail test, so we have to figure out the lower tailed probability. And you may remember we just figured that one out using t dot dist earlier on. We know it is 0, so the p-value is actually 0. Okay, some of you have a tendency of using 0 here, but this is p-value is actually for two-tailed test. It's not for one-tailed test. So what you need to do is use 0 divided by 2, but that's going to be 0 as well. So you can see it's the same. So p-value is 0. So we're going to reject the null. We're going to conclude the beta, the slope is indeed 0. So slope is less than 0. We have sufficient evidence to conclude the slope is less than 0, which also means when interest rate declines, the bank gets more requests, right? Is this statement supported by data? And you can answer yes, using the p-value, right? Part C is somewhat similar to what we just worked on. Does prime rates, X, does X have an effect on number of applications? Okay. There's a subtle difference between B and C. For C, it just says, does it have an effect? For B, it says, does it have a negative effect? Right? Okay. So for C, what you want to do is you want to write down an alternative. The null is, again, it is all related with beta 1, the slope. Because we want to see whether there's an effect. We don't care whether it's a positive or negative effect. So this is how we set up our test for part C. I'm going to write down here. And this is for part B. Right, so you can see there's a difference. For part C, we are interested to see whether there's an effect, and this is a two-tailed test. For part B, we want to see whether there's a negative effect. But everything should be the same. The test statistic, for example, t-stat, again, is negative 7.96. p-value is 0. We got 0 directly from here. We don't have to divide by 2, right? In any case, it's 0. We rejected the null, and we think the alternative is correct. So yes, there's an effect, right? For part D, you can see this is something that we have just worked on, right? For part D is something that we just worked on. It's identical to here. So you don't have to repeat it, right? Okay, the only thing that's slightly tricky is part E. Part E is an upper tailed test, right? It's an upper tailed test. Okay, so upper tailed test, and we have already done a lower tailed test. So let's see how we can work on that. They're somewhat related as well. Let me get some more space here. I'm working on part E. Okay. So beta 1 less than equal to beta 1 more than 0. So this is an upper tailed test. Okay, so let's write down the test statistic. It's a t-stat. You don't want to do any calculation. It is here, negative 7.96. Okay, we have to figure out a p-value this time. Okay, so I'm going to draw a bell curve. If you ever watched my hypothesis testing videos, you probably know I like to draw a bell curve in order to figure out a p-value. So this is 0. T18 degrees of freedom, and the test statistic is -7.96. It's very far on the left. Okay, for upper tail test, that's the one we have here, a p-value is not the small corner to the left. For upper tail test, it's always the area to the right of the test statistic you have. So that's a big area. So I'm going to draw it out here. So this shaded area is my p-value. What we know from earlier is we know the corner to the left of -7.96 is close to zero. If you know this part is very, very small, close to zero, what's the area to the right? Well, that's going to be 1 minus 0. So that means this p-value is actually close to 100%, all 1, right? So the p-value is close to 1. And in that case, you do not reject it now. You don't have enough evidence to reject it now. And you conclude beta 1 is less than or equal to 0. Right, let's move on to part F. I probably need a little bit more space here again as well. For 1% decrease in prime rate, how many more applications does the bank expect to receive and provide 95% confidence interval? So F, instead of carrying out hypothesis test, this time we're going to construct confidence interval. So let's do that. So first of all is we're considering 1% decrease. And usually if you go with the definition of a slope, we talked about 1 unit increase in X, and slope is the amount of increase in Y. But over here, you're talking about 1% decrease. Well, we know that for every 1 unit increase in X, which is prime rate, okay, 398 applications drop in Y, right? So if you have 1 unit decrease in X, you should have 398 applications more in Y, right? Okay. So we try to construct a confidence interval for the slope, and that's going to be the point estimate plus minus a multiplier times the standard error. So standard error is given to us here, 50.0242. And all we need to do is try to figure out the multiplier. Okay, this is 95% confidence interval. So for 95% confidence interval, it's a T18, which we talked about earlier. 95% confidence interval means the center is 95%. So the two corners, they add up to 5%. So each one of them is 2.5%. This is also 2.5%. So we have to figure out the multiplier here. What is this value? Well, you can use a T dot in function to figure that one out. So if you know the area of 2.5, we can figure out this one first. That's going to be T dot inf. The left area is 0.025. You want to make sure you convert it to 0.025. Okay, and the degree of freedom is 18, right? And that's going to give us the left area. I think it's going to be close to -2.101. So if this part is -2.101, you should be able to know here is +2.101, right? So that's a +2.101. And you can substitute 2.101 here into our multiplier. Okay, So now we have computed our confidence interval, and your answer should be close to 293 to 503 applications. So for every 1 unit decrease in interest rate, we expect to see about 293 to 503 more applications. Right. Let's take a look at the very last question. The very last question says, suppose the interest rate is expected to raise 5% more, and what's going to happen to our applications? 5% increase would lead to 5 times this amount of decrease of applications. So I'm going to multiply those number. And that's about 1,991.525. Okay. So there's going to be 1,992 applications less. If the interest rate raised by 5%, remember they have an opposite relationship. So the number of applications will be fewer. Right? So this concludes this video. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you in the next one.